cast your mind back to lesson one, where we briefly mentioned some misconceptions that arise when getting started with WordPress. The final topic we touched on was the confusion around WordPress.com and WordPress.org. Are they the same, or what makes them different? This is such a common cause of confusion for new WordPress users. In this lesson, we're going to take a look at what makes these two platforms different, why on earth they have the same name, and what might be the best solution for your situation. Hi, I'm Ryan. Thanks for joining us once again at the Learning Hub. The whole point of these articles and videos are to help people just like you gain a greater understanding of WordPress and equip you with the tools you need to publish amazing websites. In our last lesson, we talked about WordPress as a flexible and open source website publishing platform. Well, this is actually referring to WordPress.org, or also commonly known as self-hosted WordPress. WordPress.org allows you to download the software, install on your own server, and use it however you wish. Extend with plugins and custom code and themes until your masterpiece is complete. All of this sound familiar? Great. So now, in contrast, let's take a peek at WordPress.com and highlight some of the differences. When you arrive at WordPress.com, you're not greeted with a download link. Instead, you're prompted to sign up. That's because WordPress.com is a premium service on its own, a subscription, not a downloadable piece of software. With your paid subscription, your website is hosted on their dedicated servers. You also get a free WordPress.com domain, or you can, as most will, purchase your own top-level domain. So all this sounds amazing, right? All-inclusive hosting, nothing to set up or configure, it's all taken care of. Why would I opt to go with self-hosted WordPress when WordPress.com looks after all the technical things for me? Well, let's firstly take a look at how they stack up on price. With WordPress.com, pricing ranges from $4 a month all the way up to $45 a month. There is a free tier, but your website will display ads on it, whether you like it or not. Although this might be an attractive solution for beginner bloggers, you're very quickly going to hit a wall with what you can and what you can't do. So this more or less disqualifies it from being a viable option, especially when comparing it to the full-featured self-hosted WordPress. For the sake of comparison, you're really going to need to be on the business or e-commerce plan to come close to comparing with what you get with self-hosted WordPress. So, for an average WordPress.com business website, you're looking at upwards of $300 per year, plus the cost of your custom domain. In comparison, WordPress.org doesn't provide hosting itself, but does offer a place to start. Basic WordPress.org hosting, which gives you full access and flexibility to all of what WordPress offers, can begin as low as $70 per year, including your domain. That's a huge jump, $300 a year for WordPress.com versus $70 a year for self-hosted WordPress, and we're not actually comparing apples with apples. There will still be things you simply can't do at this level with WordPress.com that you can do with self-hosted WordPress. This is because WordPress.com is a modified version of the WordPress software. Simply put, it's a simplified and specialized version solely with the focus of getting users up and running with a simple website. So, then why cause all the confusion with the same name? Well, WordPress was co-founded by a guy named Matt Mullenweg. Matt is also the founder of Automatic, a for-profit company. Automatic has a number of projects they look after, including both the commercial WordPress.com and its open source cousin, WordPress.org. As we mentioned in the first lesson, both these versions of WordPress are the same at the very core. But as we've identified, WordPress.com puts in place a number of limitations that makes their paid platform a more streamlined service. In a way, it makes sense that their names are the same. But even with the distinct .com, .org difference, to the unaware, this isn't very obvious at first. If you're just starting out, it's actually more than likely you would get up and running with a WordPress.com website faster than you would if you chose the self-hosted WordPress route. That's WordPress.com's whole aim, and because of this, you'll pay for it. But in my experience, even though there is more to grasp with self-hosted WordPress, most users will opt for this solution. Not only because it's the cheaper price point, but as I've said before, the freedom it allows. If you're someone who's willing to learn, and by the simple fact that you're here with us now, I think self-hosted WordPress will be a great solution for whatever you choose to build with it. I've been lucky enough to have used self-hosted WordPress now for over 10 years and can honestly say it's a great choice. Even if you've never built a website before, taking advantage of resources just like this will give you the tools you need to build a cracking website. Congrats on getting to the end of lesson 3. Because you're still here, I'm glad we haven't scared you off. You're just the kind of person we're doing this course for. So buckle up, because in the next lesson, we're going to discover more of the freedom that WordPress offers. As always, if you haven't yet, make sure you join Elementor's vibrant community and check out the Academy and blog. Catch you in lesson 4.